everyone. Today I'm going to talk about physical sunscreens and share my favorites that are under $22. So I have six that I'm going to share with you today. And what I'm going to do is explain what a physical sunscreen is. I'm going to go over a little bit more info about sunscreen. I'll explain my favorites and what their benefits are, and then I'll show you how they apply to my skin and tell you a little bit more about each consistency and how they feel. But before I get into everything, if you could please do me a favor and like this video, subscribe to my channel, and ring that bell so you'll be notified every time I post a new video. I'm also really active on Instagram, and I have a blog post with everything you've ever wanted to know about sunscreen, so I will link that here for you. All right, so let's start by explaining what a physical sunscreen is. Physical sunscreens are also called mineral or inorganic sunscreen, and they contain the physical UV filters, zinc oxide, and titanium dioxide. So physical sunscreens reflect, scatter, and block a portion of the sun's rays before they penetrate into your skin. And titanium dioxide and zinc are the only physical UV filters that have been approved by the FDA for sun protection. These two ingredients are the least likely to cause adverse reactions in skin. So if you have really sensitive skin, you'll probably prefer a physical sunscreen to a chemical one. Zinc is also a really great skincare ingredient if you're acne prone. I take it as a supplement orally, and it has a lot of other benefits as well. Another benefit about physical sunscreens is that they're non-comedogenic, so they're less likely to clog your pores. Any sunscreen that you buy, you want it to say broad spectrum on the label, and everything I'm going over today does say that. But the reason you want that is because there's two types of rays that are known to really damage your skin. So there's UVA rays that, think A equals aging. UVA rays are the ones that cause premature aging. So they're present year round and they penetrate through clouds and glass. So you need to wear SPF daily because that's the one that destroys your collagen and elastin and it ages our skin. It also contributes to skin cancer, but so does UVB. So UVB is what actually burns your skin. Think B is burning, which is the sunburn, and that also contributes to aging. And you want to apply your SPF last in your skincare routine, but before your makeup. So before any of you ask, is makeup a good enough coverage, like makeup with SPF? And the answer is no, because you should be applying half of a teaspoon of SPF to your face and neck, and that would be a lot of makeup. So chances are you wouldn't be applying enough. So the reason that I really like affordable sunscreen is because you have to pile on so much product to get the amount of protection that you need. And if you're buying $50 a bottle sunscreen, you're probably not gonna wanna use as much as you should. So that's why I've been testing all of these affordable sunscreen options, because honestly, you have to probably buy a new bottle every month. So if you're gonna spend anywhere from $9.99 to $22, these are sunscreens that I genuinely love and trust and use regularly. So things that I look for in a sunscreen are minimal white cast. White cast is that like white filmy layer that some sunscreens give you. And this actually avoidable, but a lot of physical sunscreens do give you a white cast because the zinc and the ingredients are so thick. So a lot of physical sunscreens are usually tinted. I'm looking for one that doesn't cake out or makeup, it doesn't ball or pill up, it's not tacky and sticky, and it doesn't feel heavy. And because you have to apply so much sunscreen, I mean, half of a teaspoon is a lot of product. I'll show you how much that actually is. You need a sunscreen that's gonna be comfortable for you to wear every day. So the SPF number tells you how long the sun's UV radiation would take to redden your skin when you're using the product exactly as described. So for example, if you're wearing an SPF 30, which I never suggest going under an SPF 30, it would take you 30 times longer to burn than if you weren't wearing any sunscreen at all. So many of the sunscreens I'm going to talk about today do have some really cool skincare benefiting ingredients, but I wouldn't just count on your sunscreen for your skincare, because the whole point of a sunscreen is to form a film on the surface of your skin, and that would prevent these ingredients from even going deep enough for you to really notice any results. But it doesn't mean they're not doing something, it's just probably not quite enough for what you're looking for. Before I get into any of the products, I do want to say that 4 out of the 6 are tinted, and a lot of physical sunscreens you'll find today actually do have a tint because of that white cast. So they're trying to counteract that white appearance on your skin by adding some color to it. But the ingredient that they use to provide the color is usually iron oxide. In the 4 I'm talking about today, it is iron oxide. And iron oxide is actually really, really great in sunscreens because it broadens the spectrum of protection of the product. So this is going to give you extra coverage, basically. First is the Dermatology Tinted Moisturizer with SPF 46. This product is $21. You get 1.7 ounces. It has 12% zinc and 7.5% octinoxate, which is a chemical UV filter. It's oil-free and fragrance-free, and I would say that this one gives you a glowy finish. So Dermatology makes really high-end but affordable skincare products. It does have some really cool skincare ingredients. So the first one is sodium hyaluronate, which has a lower molecular weight than hyaluronic acid. That means it's more easily absorbed into your pores and it can go deeper. So hyaluronic acid works at the surface level of your skin. You've probably heard of hyaluronic acid in basically every skincare product today. It's great for surface level for smoothing and hydrating, but sodium hyaluronate does the same thing at a deeper level. So that's going to help reduce signs of aging and just make you look really plump and youthful. It also has niacinamide, which is vitamin B3. It's great for anti-aging, soothing, calming, brightening, and it balances your sebum production. It also just improves your skin's texture. Another cool ingredient that Dermatology has, which is new to me, is knotweed extract, and it helps protect you from the infrared radiation, which is said to be just as damaging as UVA and UVB. And then it also has vitamin E, which is an antioxidant. So that will block free radicals from damaging your skin. So I love antioxidants in skincare. I use a vitamin C serum every single morning because you want to block free radicals. Free radicals are in things like pollution and just basically the daily environment that we're living in. But what they do is they attack your skin cells, so they can't work at full capacity. So if your skin cells are damaged, then your skin's not going to look as great. So it's not going to be as glowy. It's not going to be as happy looking. And so you want to use some sort of antioxidant in your skincare routine. And I love that this has that in it. But next is a tinted sunscreen from CeraVe. It is a hydrating sunscreen. It has SPF 30 and it's $15 for 1.7 ounces. So out of the 4 tints I'm going to talk about today, this one is definitely the darkest and it has a really beautiful glowy finish. But I would say if you have dry skin, this would be perfect for you. This one has a 5.5% titanium dioxide and 10% zinc oxide. It's also fragrance-free and it's water-resistant for up to 80 minutes. So all of the CeraVe products have ceramides, and ceramides are amazing in skincare because they lock in moisture and they restore our skin barrier. So if your skin's ever been damaged, you've used too many acids or something went wrong, ceramides will help heal your skin. They also protect you from environmental aggressors like irritants and pollution. So same thing as like an antioxidant. This also has niacinamide and hyaluronic acid. The next one is from Australian Gold. This is their Botanical Tinted Face Sunscreen. It has SPF 50, it's $14, and you get 3 ounces. So that's probably the most affordable. It's 4% zinc and 4% titanium dioxide, so it's a 100% physical sunscreen. It's also water resistant for up to 80 minutes and fragrance free. And this one dries down to this really nice matte finish. They actually reformulated it into 3 different shades. So there's now a light, medium, and dark. I just have the original one, which I would say is more light to medium. So Australian Gold also has their antioxidant combo. They use Kakuto plum, eucalyptus, and red algae to, again, help protect your skin from daily aggressors. This one also has shea butter and squalene, which is an antioxidant that helps to hydrate, and then vitamin B5, which helps your skin retain moisture. The next one is from Ulta, and this is their Mineral Matte Tinted Face Lotion. This one has SPF 30. You get 2 ounces for $9.99, so it's definitely very affordable, and it gives you 3% zinc oxide and 3% titanium dioxide. So it's water resistant for up to 80 minutes, but it is not fragrance free. This one does have a pretty strong fragrance, but I actually like the smell and I'm very sensitive to smell, so it works for me. This one dries down matte, so if you are more oily, this would be perfect for you. And it also has shea butter and evening primrose, which helps hydrate the skin and just keep it looking really supple and beautiful. I take evening primrose also as this supplement, and it's really good for helping with acne and PMS. So I'm gonna link my beauty supplement blog post in this for you because there's so many great supplements out there. This also has green tea and cucumber, so it helps soothe and hydrate your skin. This next one is from Misha, and this is probably one of my all-time favorite sunscreens. It seriously is just so, I can't even explain it. I feel like this is my top recommended sunscreen whenever someone asks me what to use. Unless you have dry skin, I always say this one because it is just so elegantly formulated. It is a Korean beauty sunscreen and they just get it. They just understand how to make products glide and dry perfectly on your skin. So I actually thought that this was a chemical sunscreen for the longest time. And then I realized as I was writing my SPF blog post that this is a physical sunscreen, and I was so excited I couldn't even handle it. I just love physical sunscreens. I have melasma, so if I had to choose, I would choose a physical sunscreen. Not saying that chemical is bad, I just like the idea of preventing any heat that I can from getting into my skin because that aggravates your melasma. This is the Misha Soft Finish Sun Milk. So this one has SPF 50, and you'll notice that it says PA++++ on it. That is, I'm gonna explain what that is. This one is also waterproof and sweatproof, but it is not fragrance free, but I absolutely love the fragrance. It just feels so, it feels expensive and like luxurious. So sunscreens from other countries honestly are probably more advanced than American sunscreens because we have the FDA that is kind of holding us back. They haven't approved a new ingredient for sunscreen for like 20 years or something ridiculous. So you're gonna start seeing the PA factor on a lot of sunscreens, hopefully in the United States. They're already in other countries. So the PA is basically a way to measure the UVA protection. So you're gonna see things that say like 1+ sign to 4+ signs. 4+ signs is the most that you could possibly get. All right, back to the Misha sunscreen. So this one has a cooling effect that just feels good when you apply it. I actually didn't realize that that was what it was. I thought the sunscreen just felt really good when you applied it, but it doesn't tingle. It's not like minty cooling. It just feels refreshing on your skin. It also has antioxidants that protect your skin from pollution and UV rays and all the things. And then it has golden root, guava leaf, cinchona, verbena, and aloe vera. And those are natural skin barrier strengtheners. So those are just gonna help keep your skin healthy. All right, and then the last one I'm going to talk about today is from Purito. This is their Unscented Comfy Water Block. This is SPF 50, and you'll notice that this one has PA++++. So this is like the maximum version plus you can get. So UVA protection. This one is $16 for 2 ounces. It's oil-free. It's non-drying, so the Misha can be a little bit drying. I would say this one isn't. This one dries more normal like a moisturizer. So this one has cica, which is a really soothing and calming ingredient that's proven to help with wound healing. It also has niacinamide and it's perfect for sensitive skin. So if you have rosacea, this one would be great for you. And that's it. That's all my top favorite $22 and under physical sunscreens. All right, thank you so much for watching this video. I hope that you found it informative, and I hope that you found some new sunscreens that you want to test out. All of these sunscreens are so good, and they definitely pass my sunscreen requirements. So if you have any questions about these sunscreens, maybe how they would work for your skin type, or I don't know, whatever your questions may be, please leave them in the comments, or you can direct message me on Instagram. Also, if you have a sunscreen that you absolutely love, leave it in the comments because I'm always looking for new products to try. And yeah, those are my favorite physical sunscreens. They're super affordable and I would vouch for all of these. So thank you guys so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed this and I will see you next time.